Hey everyone, welcome to the channel Commerce and Management Studies. So in this video, I'm going to explain the concept of money. We are going to cover the functions of money as well as the forms of money. So let's first define what is money. Money is basically any commodity that is accepted as a medium of exchange and a measure of value. That means money is ऐसी commodity है जिसे हमने exchange के लिए accept कर लिया है. For example, if I want to buy something and go to the market and I ask for that thing, so in return of that I can pay in terms of money. So it has become a medium of exchange and it is a measure of value. For example, I have let's say a cow with me. What is the value of that cow? That can be ascertained in terms of money. That can be found out in monetary values. So money is a commodity that has been accepted as a medium of exchange as well as a measure of value. Now, this is not a very comprehensive definition because money has a lot of functions and money does a lot of things. It is not just a medium of exchange or a measure of value, but still, these are the core things which we identify money as. Because money, in simple terms, is not just the paper currency or the coins that we have. Money comes in various forms. So any form, basically anything that is accepted as a medium of exchange and as a measure of value can be termed as money. So this is the definition of money. Next we come, what are the forms of money? As I told you, there are many things that are accepted as a medium of exchange or a measure of value. Now what are these things? What are the various forms of money? Or we can also understand it like the evolution of money. How has the money evolved over the period of time? So let's see one by one. What were the various things that were accepted as a medium of exchange and a measure of value over the past years? So let's see the forms or the evolutions of money. First, as you can see, we have that is called the commodity money. Now, commodity money is that money which used to exist in the barter system. Barter system, we used to use things, we used to use commodities as a medium of exchange and a measure of value. एक person की wealth, उसके पास कितनी cows हैं, उससे measure की जाती थी. एक person की wealth, उसके पास कितने grains और कितनी rice है, उससे measure की जाती थी. So that was commodity money. It was used in terms of barter system, in times of barter system. After commodity money came the metallic coins. Metallic coins, you must have heard in the times of Akbar and all the kings and all. उस time पे coins की बहुत value होती थी. They were like gold coins, there were silver coins, there were copper coins. So metallic coins were also one form of money that was accepted as a medium of exchange as well as a measure of value. Now the problem with the commodity money, but the problem with the metallic money was that when at the time of kings they used to use gold and silver, the problem was the quality of gold. I mean, what quality of metal are you using to make the coin? So these coins, they represented the face value. Okay, they did not represent the intrinsic value. Intrinsic value means, अगर एक gold coin की value, let's say एक gold coin की value 100 rupees है, तो ज़रूरी नहीं है उसमें 100 rupees का ही gold डला हुआ है, right? So that was the problem at that time. That was the problem with the metallic coins, that whether the material that they are using in those coins has the worth or not. So that is why metallic coins did not last very long. After that, the third form of money, the most widely used form of money that we use today is the paper money. Paper money is the currency notes that we use, 10 rupee, 50 rupee, 100 rupee notes that you have seen. That is called paper money. Again, this is a token money. Token money in the sense that paper that I hold in my hand, its value is not 100 rupees, but it is written 100 rupee over there. It is a promissory note. If you see on every currency note, there is written, I promise to pay the bearer this much sum of money. So, उस पर क्योंकि 100 लिखा है, इसलिए उसकी value 100 rupees की है. उस paper की value 100 rupees की नहीं है, right? So, this is a token money. Again, it is not the intrinsic value. But still, this is the most widely used form of money today. That is called paper money. After paper money, also that came was the bank deposits. Now, we know there are three types of deposits. Saving deposits, there are current account deposits, and then there are fixed deposits. Of course, saving deposits or fixed deposits, we cannot use them for, you know, very common transactions. But the current account deposits, that current account can be used for quick transactions, right? So bank account deposits, like, you can easily use it as a medium of exchange or a measure of value. This is also one form of money. And nowadays, the latest form of money that has come to be is the plastic money. What is plastic money? Plastic money is the debit and the debit cards and the credit cards that we have. These have now become the paperless form of money. Again, they can be used as a medium of exchange and they can also be used as a measure of value. So these are the various forms of money, and also I have placed them that you understand them like the evolution of money. So this was the concept of forms and the evolution of money. Next topic that we do is the functions of money. Money kya functions perform karta hai? To remember the functions of money, I wanted to remember this quote. Money is a matter of function four, a measure, a medium, a standard, a store. If you just remember this quotation, it's a very beautiful poem. You can easily remember the four functions of money. Money is a matter of function four, a measure, a medium, a standard, a store. So let's see all these functions of money one by one. First is the measure of value. As I told you, money hame cheezon ki value kitni hai ye batata hai. For example, let's go to the barter system time. I have a cow and I want to sell that cow, and the other person has rice with it. How much rice have to be exchanged for a cow? It is very difficult, because money hi ek aisi commodity hai jiski value more or less stable rehti hai. For example, 100 rupee ka note, I mean aaj bhi 100 ka hai aur bahut time tak wo 100 ka hi rahega. Bahut rarely hota hai ki uski like purchasing power kam hogi ya zyada hogi. That is not very frequent. Lekin money ke alawa jitni bhi commodities hain उनकी वैल्यू बहुत फ्रीक्वेंटली चेंज होती है. तो मनी क्योंकि बहुत स्टेबल कमोडिटी है कंपेयर टू अदर कमोडिटीज, मनी को हम एज अ मेजर ऑफ वैल्यू यूज कर सकते हैं. सो मनी का फर्स्ट फंक्शन, इट इज़ अ मेजर ऑफ वैल्यू. सेकेंड फंक्शन, इट इज़ अ मीडियम ऑफ एक्सचेंज. दैट इज इन द डेफिनेशन ऑफ मनी ऑल्सो. मनी एक ऐसी जनरली एक्सेप्टेड कमोडिटी है जिसे एक्सचेंज के लिए यूज़ किया जा सकता है. यू कैन बाई ऑलमोस्ट एनी थिंग फॉर मनी. सो मनी इज़ अ मीडियम ऑफ एक्सचेंज. थर्ड फंक्शन आता है, मनी इज़ अ स्टैंडर्ड फॉर डेफर्ड पेमेंट्स. एज यू नो, बाय टुडे पे टुमारो. आज आप खरीद लीजिए, पेमेंट कल कर दीजिएगा. सो इफ टुडे आई गिव यू, लेट्स से आई गिव यू कमोडिटी एक्स, एक साल बाद आपको मुझे कितने पैसे पे करने हैं, इंटरेस्ट रेट कितना होना चाहिए. सो दैट्स वाई मनी हैज़ कम टू अ रेस्क्यू. इट हेल्प्स अस टू पे द थिंग्स, पे फॉर सर्टेन थिंग्स एट अ लेटर डेट. हम उसको फ्यूचर में उसके लिए पे कर सकते हैं, बिकॉज अगेन मनी की जो वैल्यू है वो कंपेयर टू अदर कमोडिटीज स्टेबल रहती है. सो मनी हैज़ बिकम अ स्टैंडर्ड फॉर डेफर्ड पेमेंट्स एज वेल. एंड द लास्ट इज मनी एज अ स्टोर ऑफ वैल्यू. मनी को हम फ्यूचर यूज़ के लिए स्टोर कर सकते हैं. कमोडिटीज पेरिशेबल इन नेचर होती हैं. हर कमोडिटी को फ्यूचर के लिए सेव नहीं किया जा सकता. ऑफकोर्स गोल्ड को भी सेव किया जा सकता है, बट अगेन गोल्ड की वैल्यू उतनी स्टेबल नहीं होती है एज कम्पेयर टू मनी. मनी, द वैल्यू ऑफ मनी इज़ वेरी स्टेबल इन फ्यूचर ऑल्सो कम्पेयरटिवली टू अदर कमोडिटीज. सो मनी को हम फ्यूचर अनसर्टिनिटीज़ के लिए सेव कर सकते हैं. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, बैंक अकाउंट, सेविंग अकाउंट, डिपॉजिट अकाउंट और एनी अदर इन्वेस्टमेंट. सो मनी इज़ अ स्टोर ऑफ वैल्यू ऑल्सो. सो दीज आर द फोर फंक्शंस ऑफ मनी. मनी इज़ अ मैटर ऑफ फंक्शन फोर, अ मेजर, अ मीडियम, अ स्टैंडर्ड, अ स्टोर. So in this video, we have covered the topics of forms of money, we have covered the definition of money, and we have also done the functions of money. I hope you understand the topic. If you like the video, please give a thumbs up and do subscribe to the channel. I'll be coming with more videos like that. Anyhow, in the next video, I'm going to start with the topics of theories of money demand. Thank you so much. Keep learning.